It's October 2022, Jumeirah Beach, Dubai, Burj Al Arab. People out swimming, running, surfing, jogging. God, running. Should definitely get into that. A far cry from March of 2020. A month that would have changed our lives in ways we would never still understand.
Chinese health authorities are still working to identify the virus behind a pneumonia outbreak in the central city of Wuhan.
I have today declared that the coronavirus presents a public health emergency in the United States.
Stay at home.
Stay home, stay safe.
Quite simply, stay at home.
I mean, here we are on Sheikh Zayed. Six lane highway, six lanes each side, one of the busiest roads in Dubai. And during COVID, and empty. This is a road that is normally a parking lot. And here we are in the middle of March, and nothing, not a single car. And during this chaos of a once in a generation time, houses became many things, became restaurants, sanitation stations, and for some of us, we had to create offices. I was pretty lucky to be able to make a bit of a dream setup for myself. Now, obviously, my office became something a little bit more than that. Hey Google, let's do this.
You got it, firing up the battle station now.
Through the chaos and uncertainty of COVID, there was a bit of a savior that came in to help us all. March 10th, 2020 will live on as a very important day in the eye of many gamers and especially the COD community. Like millions worldwide, a merry band of haunts was able to run through Verdansk together. We'll be able to connect it across the world, finding each other in Verdansk. Cheers, my love.
Bye, baby.
Instead of catching real planes, we dropped in on a virtual plane to hang out with each other on the fields of Verdansk.
Full bukkake.
How do you chat with a posse?
Very quickly. Team up, triple kill. Oh fuck.
Callback station, superstar. Dead.
I'm down, but all his armor's gone. Ooh.
Got him! I'll drive. That way we know we won't die.
Yeah, we know I'll die.
Open fire! How are you missing him?
Good one.
Tunnel three, please.
Of dropping. Some of us didn't have the best of luck and ended up tuxing it. Nicknamed off a friend of ours that was the first to do this, you know, dropping in without your parachute, running that badge of dishonor that definitely carried through the entire game.
Shit. Oh, nice one, Brew.
There's a whole three.
Careful.
Top of
yeah,
room,
so. I'm gonna get fucked here because.
In the bush here.
Oh! Oh, Carla!
Go big, go home,
do it, boy.
Hell.
Jeez.
Where's the oh, Tex! Holding out?
I'm bitch.
I think you got this. 100%. Steve's
soft tech, yep. Oh, I got sniped.
How'd you get sniped already, bro?
Straight side, bro. Straight side.
Sometimes you need to use a vehicle to adapt, and they don't always go according to plan.
Turn right. Jesus Christ. What is going on here? Oh, oh, oh shit. Oh.
That just happened.
Oh, yeah, soft ice,
thanks for it. Have a good one.
Just sometimes, Badask leaves you a little bit shooketh with its effect moments.
Oh, we fucking go right here! Oh, Jesus Christ! Like, oh! Oh my God! Oh, what? Internally. You know you're supposed to be guarding me not through the fucking bushes, right? But it's supposed to stop C4.
Didn't shoot it, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Dubai International Airport, where the local time is 5 a.m. and the outside temperature is 28 degrees Celsius. Please keep your seatbelt fastened until the seatbelt sign has been switched off. Thank you for flying Emirates in partnership with South African Airways. We hope you enjoyed your flight and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
Whilst Warzone 1 was a lot of fun, there were a couple things that just didn't go right. I got to spend some time with my boy Solo, really kind of discussed them a little bit. Asked some poignant questions that I think are going to be super important when it comes to Warzone 2.0.
What was your first thoughts about seeing Verdansk?
Do you know what's funny about that is I don't even think it had anything to do with the game. Because we jumped in and I just saw like all this open space, and at that stage we were in lockdown and I was in a little flat for like days, and I just thought to myself like, look at all that space, that's amazing. That will forever have a place in my heart. It's kind of like Verdansk over Caldera.
Yes, but which Verdansk?
Which Verdansk?
Yeah, because there was
second iteration, I would say. I like the color of the second Verdansk.
Did you though? It was very mustardy.
No, because I could see.
This is true.
All the blacks were gone, bro.
This is true.
So, like all those little pusnayas in the corner there in their rose skins, you could actually see them.
Yeah.
However, I preferred the modern vibe of the first
one. How did Verdansk and like Warzone affect your views on COVID and lockdown?
I think you were the same, and I suppose for a lot of it, it's like we were locked in a small apartment and it was kind of just like an escape. Yeah, so for us it was like 10-12 hours a day, every day. It was like an escape, like I said to you just now. I jumped in, it felt like I could be outside running around, you know. It was just a cool escape. I think back of lockdown now and I just think of this game and I think of us just jamming, having the time of our lives, like we had varsity again and like lectures. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, 100%. And besides Blackout, what were you playing before Warzone dropped?
So we are COD fanboys. So it would have been whatever the multiplayer was. The only other little adventure we had with Battle Royales and other games actually was we played H1Z1 for a little while.
Okay, very cool. So you were fairly accustomed to like the Battle Royale like kind of mentality. Before Warzone, what did you think of the BR format?
Yeah, well, so like with H1Z1, like a pile of shit, really. Yeah.
Top three best memories of Warzone?
River Town Old Faithful. It's not a specific memory.
Yeah.
But a memory I always think of, as soon as you say Verdansk, I think of us jumping in and like just before you're about to land, you can see like the whole of River Town Old Faithful. Like that memory to me, I'll always remember when everyone's like Warzone Verdansk, what do you remember? I'll be like, jumping in with the haunts.
Yep.
You know, you like jump in like that. That's like that memory I love. You and me playing in that one tournament in lockdown.
The Red Alert.
I will always, yes. Dude, I will always remember that. And then more specifically when we got that 20 piece. So I think I got like 19 kills and you got 21.
Yeah.
Whatever it was in that like mode, that like Jurors mode. We'd have that set thing like.
Yeah.
We go into the cash thing, we get cash straight away, and then we start dominating Storage Town. And
buyback trios.
Up being in Storage Town. And then that memory of us winning, one of us shot the oak on the hill.
Yeah.
And we were just going, dude, we went apoplectic. Like,
dude, I think
screaming, like I loved that win.
I think we got like three wins that day.
Yeah.
And for us, that was great. And that was
tops.
There was one second place up there by farmlands called by the pineapples, and there was a guy in a bush that fucking sneaky puff adder got us.
I think even funnier than that is when Stu was in A-frame
near
the bank building.
Yeah,
and he was like, "Oh, they're coming inside of me. They're coming inside of me." And Ruth's like, what? What? He was like, never mind.
Oh my god. Favorite meta or metas?
Oh, DMR meta. I love
it. Really?
No fucking way. That thing was horseshit.
Okay, I was about to say.
That is an absolute bazinga.
Can you hear the fishing line just go on? Fucking, I was like, wait, what? Am I talking to Stew?
but you know me. You know exactly what my answer can be. Kilo MP5 meta.
Really? Yeah.
Straight.
Yeah.
Straight. Do you know what actually maybe comes close? But that's also because in the beginning of the game, so like we also had that like honeymoon phase.
Yeah.
When we had the HDR. I can't remember what we paired.
HDR thermal. And then
thermal.
MP7 or an MP5.
Yes.
Yeah.
Those would probably be my favorite two metas.
For me, would have to be Growl Bruin.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you remember the Bruin when it was popping off?
To me, also metas aren't just a gun. Obviously, it's a lot of it has to do with a gun, but it's also the time that we found ourselves in playing.
Yeah.
Like, that kilo meta for me, I just love the gun. That gun and me were like, toy.
Yeah.
But we also, I think at my happiest then because we were jamming, there was like no real SBMM.
Wasn't as many hackers.
Like awesome phase in the game where like we were just like super stoked to play.
Yep. Best and worst in game event.
Okay, well, the worst is easy. It's that train piece of shit. That thing.
I think that is universal.
Yeah, dude, that was a flaming piece of shit. The best, I don't know what it was called. It's like the one where you were like running to stadium and like you could get wood.
It was the first in-game event they did, and they gassed the stadium. Your biggest frustrations with Warzone?
Number one is SBMM.
Yep.
I think a lot of people that missed out on the lockdown Warzone, they probably won't understand like how good it was to play with soft SBMM on. Fast forward to Caldera now, where it's Sweatfest 5000.
With all this in mind,
What
do you want to see in Warzone 2.0?
What I'd like to see, maybe it's not actually like a game thing, maybe it's more of like an attitude thing, is what these Nias do the whole time is they will get, say for example, Caldera. They'll get it over the course of a year or however long it's been out for. to a place like now. Like now it's great. Like, okay, we don't like the map, but think of like the balloons and like how you can get around, and it's a great map from that perspective. Like they've listened to people finally. It took about a year and a half because they never ever do anything we want them to until everyone throws all their toys out the cart continually. And they see it costs them money, then they want to listen.
Yep.
If there's anything I want to see in Warzone, it's a continuation of Caldera in terms of like the beautiful place they got it, rather than their usual modus operandi, which is pretend that they don't, you know, that they've forgotten about all of the stuff they've done and they're going to start off with a shit map. And why I say that is, if you looked at the COD next, what are these assholes going to do? They're going to change the looting system. Why? Fine-tuned it to such a dope level that it was quick.
Yep.
But it was quick for PC and it was quick for controller. Like, it was quick for everyone.
Yep.
Like, the looting was is dope.
Yep.
It's like, it was in a good place.
Yep.
And so, it's things like that. It's like, why are you changing things that aren't broken, bro? All they need to do is say, like, sit down and literally have like a 10-hour powwow on what's working in Caldera.
Yep.
Take that base and then what didn't work and fine-tune that.
Yep.
And put a really dope map on.
Yep.
Like, I don't think that's asking for much. And that's actually what I would like to see in Warzone 2. Because then we get a workable game on a map we love.
Amazing. Yep, I agree with you.
If there's anything I really want to see, proximity chat. I think it has such potential to be a game changer. Just add a little bit of something that no other game really has, where you can shit talking when you're in the same proximity, like Final Circle. Think about how cool that would be.
Yeah. Come on, little bitch. Let's go. Guns, knives only, knives only. Let's go.
No, I'm not trying to suggest I took an entire trip to Cape Town just to make this video. I mean, that would be freaking awesome if I'd been able to plan that. But simply put, Warzone transcended gaming, transcended an era, transcended a time when we needed something more. Over the last 2 years, it got bad. It got really bad. If you look at my stats, I was playing I played something like 400 hours of Warzone. I guarantee you, only 10% of that is in the last year. When all the hacking started happening in the game, we kind of dropped off.
I wake up every morning, and what's the first thing I put on? An espresso video, an Ace video. I'm like, this is how I'm starting my day. The wife gets me a cup of coffee. She's like, are we watching I was like, you know how things go, babe. It's Call of Duty first thing in the morning. Go see what's happening. What are the changes? What's the new guns? It's like, oh, okay, cool. I'll sip on my coffee. And then comes 10 p.m. at night, and I want to hang myself by my own fucking testicles and shit in my keyboard and just go, because that's how this fucking game drives me insane.
I haven't bought a skin in Warzone in a year and a half, and I don't want to see that happen in Warzone 2. Yes, I want to have epic moments.
Fuck you.
Oh, it's
all
fucking team.
Oh,
there's Oaks pushing it. I'm gonna hit the back Oaks, I'm gonna hit the front Oak. I'm gonna hit the Oak on the right, I'm gonna hit the Oak on the left.
I'm gonna go on the front here. Go.
Go.
Okay, we both hit the back Oak.
Oh, you got him. Oh, well played.
Gas is inbound. Marking you safe zone.
Oh, they're trying to claim more time.
Give me babies.
One upstairs, one
upstairs. Stop shooting, little motherfucker.
Of course, I'm going to go on top of our team. The team at the loadout.
Drop one. Drop two.
And yes, I want to get amazing wins with my mates.
Size roll first.
Ooh.
What? What did he get? Shit. Hey.
Two more size. Must be in there, bro.
1v1.
Booyah! Down one. Yes, please!
Yeah, well done, chaps.
Okay, then. Got self-raise. Let's go! Yes! Yes!
Get him, Solo. Watch out there, watch out there. Yes, boys!
But I also want to enjoy the game. I want to remember Warzone for that time that brought such joy to our lives when we needed it so much. And right now, gaming needs it. Right now, the community needs a game like Warzone 2 to succeed. So I guess in closing for this video, Warzone, you were amazing. Like any great TV series, when something fundamental changes, it loses that spark. It loses that thing that made it special. Michael Scott, when he left The Office, that was it. The Office should have ended. Or like when Childish Gambino left Community, it was kind of the end of the series. It should have ended there. It should have ended on a high note. But instead it carried on dragging on. And I feel like Caldera was that. The end of Warzone. It was the final nail in the coffin that just confirmed that they kind of lost that little something. And whilst there's some cool changes happening in the new Warzone 2.0, which, like proximity chat, which is now confirmed and it looks amazing, I can't help myself wonder what next is Activision going to bring in to ruin it? To ruin the game that we love, that's brought me into this community, that has allowed me to meet people from across the world, to start getting into streaming in the way that I have. Warzone, you have a lot riding on your shoulders. Warzone 2.0 is already looking like a hit. But let's just hope that greed, unnecessary need to constantly try to reinvent yourself, doesn't break the game. Don't be scared to be bold. Don't be scared to throw balloons up like they did in Apex and just own it. Fortnite have done it for years and nobody complains there. I'm excited for Warzone 2.0. I'm excited for this journey. I really hope that it's going to bring our community back together. And I really hope to see you guys in the chat soon. So with that, I say Warzone, you have been great. You have been kind. I will miss you 1.0. But 2.0, it's time for you to suit up. You take care now. Bye-bye then. Ha ha ha.